In this tutorial, I'll show you how to model and render a joystick. I'll post a link to this tutorial's reference image in the description below. Scale the cube and bevel the vertical edges in the middle. Press Ctrl B to bevel and please remember to use the mouse wheel to add more segments. Auto smooth to correct the normal issues. Extrude the top face. Duplicate the cube and scale it like this. Extrude the top face and scale it. Let's create a cylinder. Shift D to duplicate and S to scale. Let's duplicate the main cylinder one more time. Create a UV sphere for the top piece. Create a cylinder for the button base. Extrude and scale the top face. Create a cube and subdivide it. We can make the top button mesh like this. Press Ctrl R to add a loop cut and bring it up. Please remember to add a cast modifier. Let's add the materials. Select both button meshes and press Ctrl J to join them. Let's mirror the mesh. Create a curve point, and press the 3D button. If you don't see the curve point, please activate an add-on called Add Curve, Extra Objects. Turn off the normal indicator. Extrude the curve point. We need to select the sharp edge points and press V and A to turn them into smooth edges like this. Let's apply the material and fill the end cap. Create and scale a cylinder to create a decorative mesh for the cable mesh. Create a ground plane and turn it into a light bouncing wall. Please watch a tutorial listed in the description to match my final render settings, as I'm using a cloned look dev HDRI setting. Let's add a point light in place in front of the joystick mesh. We can barely see the details on the joystick mesh. This is optional, but we can always use Photoshop to enhance the render image by adjusting the levels like this. This is before. This is after. This is the end of the joystick tutorial. Please like and subscribe if you have enjoyed watching this tutorial. Thank you for watching.